Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to use Gemini AI API with Android Kotlin. So let's get started. So first thing, just Google Gemini AI API. You'll be getting the first link as build with the Gemini API. Just click that and you need to sign in with your Google account. After signing in, just click on this get API key in Google AI Studio. You'll be taken to an interface like this. Here you can type any prompt and get a sample response from the Gemini AI API. So now we are good, and to the left you will be having this documentation option. Just click it, and here to the left we'll be having this getting started tutorials. Expand this, and if you scroll down you'll be having Android. Click that, and here we will be having all the necessary code for our Android, which comes in both Kotlin as well as Java. So if you just scroll down, here you can see we are having Kotlin and Java, and this literally covers all the Gemini AI API, that is the text to text and image to text, everything, okay? So let me just go down, and here we'll be having the sample code along with the dependencies. So we're just going to follow these instructions, okay? And currently I'm having here a sample Kotlin app, just a demo app that I'm having over here, and let's begin to code now. So first thing, here it says this is the dependency that we are going to add. Let me just copy this, and I need to put in this app module build.gradle. So I will go to my project, expand the Gradle scripts. Here I'm having the app module. Click it, and if I scroll down, I'm having the dependencies. I will just paste this over here and just click on sync now. So the Gradle build will happen. This is good. I'll go to my main activity again. And if I scroll down, this is a necessary thing for my text from text only input. So we will be using the Gemini Pro, which is a text model. And this is the code, literally this is the code, that's it. So I'll just copy the sample code. And here, let me just create a function. It's going to be public fun. Let me call it as model call, something like this. And just paste the code, and we're getting an error for this. If I just hover over it, we'll be getting import class because we are done with the dependencies. That's it, this has been imported, and it's throwing us an error for build config. In this case, I'm just directly going to hard code the API since this is just a demo purpose, hard coding the API key. In case if you're going to do for production, I would recommend you to do this build config thing, okay? And now it is throwing error for generate content. It says suspend function generator should be called directly from another suspend function. So for solving this issue, we can use the main scope.launch. So just type main scope.launch. So this helps us in resolving this concurrency issue whenever we call or fetch from a model or API. So I'm just going to put this piece of code inside this and also print that thing also inside over this. Yeah. So this is fine. Now we are not getting any errors. And now let me just call this function inside the onCreate function, this one. So it's going to be like this. And in case if you're having any button, you can just add this as an onClick to that button. So whenever you click on that button, this entire code will be triggered and you will be getting a response from the Gemini AI API. So you can do that. Since this is a demo, I'm just directly calling it whenever the app starts. So okay, so final thing that we want to do is put the API key. So for doing that, just go to the playground interface, and to the left we'll be having here get API key. Click this, and you need to click on this create API key. So for many of you, this option will be enabled. Since I'm already having some Google projects, I will just select that and click on create API key. Copy this, and if you feel you want to delete that, you can just delete the API key also. So I'm just going to paste it over here, the API key. Yeah, now we are good. And so let me just, completely restart my application. So the application has started successfully. And if I go to logcat, here you can see I have got a response for the story about magic backpack. I'm having the story over here. So final thing, let's see how we can display this in the UI as a text. So simple, go to activity-main.xml. By default, we'll be having this hello world, right? Let's add a ID to that. Let me go with demo text something. Yeah. And if I go to main activity, now just come inside our function, and it's going to be, you can just remove this public, yeah, it's going to be a random variable. It'll be named as text view equal to find view by ID. It's going to be of type text view, and it's r dot id dot demo text. That's the ID we have specified. And if I come down, it's going to be text view dot set text, and we need to pass the response, that text. Yeah, and we can just remove the print. So again, just rerun your application. So once the application has started, we will be getting hello world. After that, this particular function will be called, and within few seconds, our hello world text will be changed with the response. Here you can see, yeah, we are getting that story as a response over here. This is just a demo. You can just customize this based on a button click or based upon your use case, okay? So this works fine, and that's the video, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of tutorials in Gemini AI API as well as OpenAI API and other AI tools and CRUD operations. So check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.